Hey everybody, and welcome to another Call of Duty 2 mod. Last time I did the Operation Sea Lion, German invasion of Britain, and the response from you guys was great. Many of you seemed to like it, and were surprised that Call of Duty 2 had such cool custom missions and mods, and so I already knew what mod I wanted to do next. One of the best Call of Duty 2 mods, by far, that has been released is the Spanish Civil War mod. Where many modders maybe make one or two missions for Call of Duty 2, this modding team made a whole custom campaign for Call of Duty 2 about such an interesting and unexplored setting in video games. Complete with custom dialogue in Spanish, background stories, and presenting the conflict from both sides. That means we will be fighting as both the rebels and the militia supporting the government. It's great because this means that the actual conflict itself is the main character here, as we experience it all the way from the very first day of the uprising to the end 3 years later. There are a ton of new custom weapons, units, skins, buildings, props, and even armor that have been added for this mod. This is a product where you can feel the dedication and love that was put in by the modding team, as they wanted to create something they could be proud of, and in my opinion, they deliver on that. I'm quite curious if I have some Spanish viewers here that watch my videos, and if so, I do believe you owe it to yourself to play this since it's part of your history and so underused in a medium like video games. I will also do a review of this mod on the Canoe Reviews channel, so don't forget to click the link to that channel in the description down below to head on over there and subscribe to see more of my reviews. And now, without further ado, let's begin on this epic journey and start where it all began. Alright, here we go. The first level, the day of the uprising. This will be introduced by a short video of historic footage and Spanish narration. I don't know any Spanish, there are no subtitles, but I'll keep it in.
El 18 de julio de 1936, los militares más conservadores del ejército español se sublevan contra el gobierno republicano, protagonizando un alzamiento que se extiende rápidamente por todo el país, dando inicio a la Guerra Civil Española. Esta supone la culminación de años de disensiones encubiertas entre las diversas facciones, tanto políticas como sociales, que se han ido formando durante los últimos tiempos. Las fuertes diferencias económicas entre privilegiados y no privilegiados, el creciente descontento con una clase política ineficaz y el auge de las nuevas ideologías en el panorama europeo producen una escalada de tensiones en la España del momento. La Segunda República Española supuso el canto del cisne para la estabilidad de un país que desde hacía más de un siglo estaba acostumbrado a resolver sus problemas a golpe de levantamiento militar. Con la dictadura de Primo de Rivera todavía muy reciente en la memoria de los españoles, la moderación y los prometidos cambios sociales de la República dejan paso al extremismo y a la radicalización. Mientras las escuadras falangistas convierten las calles en escenarios de luchas cruentas, los sectores de izquierda contribuyen a la inseguridad general con actos de protesta y vandalismo. Se suceden los asesinatos revanchistas de uno y otro bando, las ocupaciones de fincas, las huelgas salvajes y los ajustes de cuentas, sin que un desbordado y dividido gobierno republicano llegue a actuar con firmeza. Es en este escenario cuando un grupo de militares rebeldes urde un plan para comenzar con el levantamiento que habría de traer a España estabilidad. El día del alzamiento nacional ha llegado.
All right, so now we can finally begin. There's a little bit of text to explain the situation here. July 17th, 1936. The coup was to begin with the rise of a faction of the army led by General Mola and Franco. The uprising, however, starts a day earlier than expected, when a group of conspirators are caught by an army lieutenant Zato and faithful to the legitimate government in the commission on the limits of Meia. Alerted from Madrid, Zato's squad has been sent to investigate, although their presence could end up causing rushed events.
De acuerdo, atención, está en el circuito de obstáculos y hoy se entrenará con las armas. Bien, ahora compruebe sus objetivos. Comprobará que su objetivo actual está resaltado. Además, su objetivo actual se encuentra señalado por la estrella de su brújula. Según se aproxime a su objetivo actual, la estrella se moverá hacia el centro de la brújula. Aproxímese a su objetivo actual.
That it will be you, sir.
Ya está lo bastante cerca. Se dará cuenta de que el objetivo ha quedado tachado y que en su lugar tiene otro nuevo.
Open the gate. Here we go.
Muévanse, señoritas. Salte por encima.
Jump over them. So we are actually playing as one of the Moroccan forces. Spanish Morocco. The Moroccan army played a pretty big role.
No está mal. Ahora cuerpo a tierra y arrástrese por debajo de la alambrada.
Especially in the early days of the war.
Sargento, dispare esas ametralladoras. Esa es munición real, muchachos. Agáchense.
They were really good at fighting in the open land, in the countryside. Not so much on in urban environments, though. Here we go. We got a weapon.
Acérquese a la valla y dispare seis tiros contra su objetivo.
Sí, señor. And so again, the cool thing is we will be fighting on both sides, so both the nationalists and also those for the Republic.
Cuando su cargador se vacíe, su arma se recargará automáticamente. El número de balas de su arma y el de la munición que lleva se muestran en la esquina inferior derecha de su pantalla. Tome nota de ello, soldado. Para hacerse con más munición, coja la de cualquier arma abandonada que se encuentre del mismo tipo de la que lleve. De acuerdo, soldado. Vaya a la siguiente zona.
Here we go. It's actually very cool that this mod has an like sort of like training level as well. Most mods don't deal with that because they're like, you know, you already know the vanilla game, so you don't need a training level. Melee attack. Got proper bayonet training here.
Ahora cambia de arma, soldado. A no ser que sea tan tonto como feo, se dará cuenta de que cada una es útil en determinadas circunstancias. Hacer una elección errónea puede llevarle a la tumba. Dispare tres veces más a su objetivo.
Three rounds. One, two, three.
Excepcional, soldado. Proceda a la siguiente zona.
All right. That's grenade throwing. We all know this, but again, it's very cool that they put this in here as well with, of course, the Spanish Civil War setting.
Coja las granadas de fragmentación de la mesa. ¡Cójalas! Arroje una granada a cada una de las aberturas enfrente suya.
There we go. See if we can chop this in here. And I would love to see more historic games do this, where you just fight on both sides, and just the conflict that's really the main character.
Mantenga sus armas limpias y cerca de usted todo el tiempo. Puede retirarse.
All right, dismissed. Go through less exit.
Suban por estas escaleras. Vamos, vamos, vamos.
Here we go. And even cutscenes. Look at that. Again, this mod is amazing. There's Zaro.
Identifíquese.
That we read about.
Soy el teniente Zaro y desde Madrid se nos ha ordenado inspeccionar la base. Avise al comandante.
Enseguida, señor. Teniente Coronel Gazapo a su servicio. ¿Qué asuntos traen a la Guardia de Asalto por aquí?
Señor, tenemos orden del Ministerio de realizar inventario en esta base.
Espere, he de confirmar esa orden por teléfono. No les permita entrar. Voy a intentar conseguir ayuda.
All right. So Zaro's here. He's suspecting some stuff. We're gonna get some reinforcements from the other Moroccan troops. Here we go.
El gobierno republicano ha descubierto nuestros planes. Así que debemos rescatar a los dos oficiales sublevados para asegurarnos el control de la base. Recordad, tenemos permiso para sofocar cualquier resistencia que encontremos.
Así será, Shabab.
The one who...
Debemos tomar la base. Les convenceremos de que están en el bando equivocado por las buenas o por las malas.
So the one who just talked to them is actually my character. Your character will talk in this mod, which is very cool.
No se mueva nadie. ¡Tiren las armas!
¿Qué significa esto?
La base está bajo mando del nuevo régimen nacional. ¡Están con nosotros!
Supongo que no tenemos otra opción. Ustedes mandan.
Una escuadra leal a nuestra causa está rodeada en el exterior de la base. ¡Debemos ayudarles!
¡Rápido, soldados! ¡Salvemos a nuestros camaradas!
Yes, sir. Looks like the fighting is already happening. Here we go. Oh, that's some heavy fighting already. He wanted to throw a grenade. Won't let him. I'll have a grenade for you, though.
Granada a cubierto.
Pasemos a la acción.
Cúbreme. Yo se lo quitaré de encima.
Considéralo hecho.
There we go. And fire a little bit faster with this weapon. Is that all? Yep.
Ay, el avión del general enemigo, Morato. Parece que nadie le ha alertado de que hemos ocupado la base. Aprovechemos su confusión. Hemos de capturarlo antes de que escape.
Capture the general. Now's our chance. Is that him?
General, ríndase. Es inútil continuar la lucha.
Están cometiendo alta traición. Serán fusilados en cuanto Madrid aplaste su insurrección.
Not if I can help it.
Tendrán que vencernos, general.
Hey, and that's the end of the first level. There's a lot more to come, people. I hope you guys like it, so sit back, relax, grab a Coke and a snack. Let's continue. Alright, here we have the next mission with a little bit more text explaining the situation. So the uprising spreads to slipstream Mejia the events of the Boundary Commission. A detachment of rebels are preparing to take the seaplane base of Ataleon, located in the Sichica near Mejia. Again, if I butcher some of those names or titles, I'm so sorry, I don't speak Spanish. Bear with me, please. The exhibition is being fiercely defended by forces loyal to the Republic, led by Virgilio Leret, a pilot who is exercising the leadership of the interim base. Base seaplanes. And we're still playing as the Moroccan troops.
Shabbat. Todavía siguen atrincherados en la fortaleza. El capitán Leret dice que seguirá fiel a la República hasta el fin y se niega a deponer las armas.
Condenado Virgilio. No nos deja ninguna opción. Ese cuartel es clave para la toma completa de Melilla. La sublevación depende de ello. Muchachos, vamos a tener que entrar por la fuerza antes de que llegue el apoyo enemigo. ¿Estáis listos?
¡Listos!
Alright, here we go. And as I said before in an earlier mission, the Moroccan troops, they had 30,000 in the beginning, and eventually through the war they ended up with 60,000 being called in. They actually excelled in country warfare because of their experience in northern Africa.
Tened cuidado con ese paso entre las rocas. He visto esto muchas veces antes. Es el lugar perfecto para una emboscada. ¿Quién va?
Mohamed Ben Misiana a su servicio, señor.
¿Qué hacéis aquí?
Hemos aprovechado la confusión de la batalla para rescatar a un valeroso legionario que lleva meses apresado en esta fortaleza.
¿Por qué tanto interés en ese hombre?
Me salvó la vida en una ocasión.
Comprendo. Únete a nuestra causa y te ayudaremos a encontrar a tu amigo.
Salam alaikum. Que Allah te proteja.
All right, we just got a few more troops to add to our cause. Let's actually do this.
Nada nos detendrá.
All right, boys, spread out, spread out, spread out.
Adelante,
here they come. Guy's still alive, but he's no threat. And again, what I really love, of course, the previous video that I did was the Operation Sea Lion. Oh god. There we go, finally. Operation Sea Lion, where Germany invades Britain. And I wish there were more parts in that mission where you actually had, or you were fighting amongst, you know, friendly NPCs. And this mod creator, or the creators here, properly did that, where, you know, more often than not, you are surrounded by friendly troops. Oh, God, what? Who shot him? Is there one behind here? There we go. One more. Good shot. Alright, everybody still alive? Did we lose any men? Doesn't look like it. There we go. Alright, that's the guy we rescued. Virgilio. That's how you pronounce it. Virgilio. And again, it looks a little rough, maybe, compared to like the vanilla game. But again, the fact that they went through this to create this map is really cool. It feels really unique. Do you not get it open, Private? Let me help you. Alright, boys, inside. Come on. Follow me. That hopefully did some damage. Oh, we got one more to the right. There we go. Kinda looks clear. Let's check the base. Oh, one at the door. Be careful, Ali. You got him? Oh. Merciless Ali. That was his nickname in the war. Just gonna check if there's something up here. Again, really cool. A lot of new textures, photos, maps, paintings that they used. Very, very cool. Love all the details. Oh! Look out, Jamal. Cúbreme. Considera lo hecho. Come on, show your face. We know you're in there. Still alive. Get him. There you go. Is this him? Is this Virgilio? Okay. Seems like he's not a threat. Oh! They throw a grenade. Look out, Ali! Oh, Ali's dead. Oh, God! Merciless Ali. His career, his military career was short-lived. Alright, there we go. Seems like that's it. Let's capture the captain. Cut enemy communications. Okay, over there. You can already see that this mission is quite a lot more action-packed than the previous one. Very, very cool. Do I need to shoot it? Or just press F? Alright, that should be it probably then. Hands up, Virgilio. You're ours now.
Hemos aplastado al enemigo. Pero todavía queda un largo camino que recorrer en la península. Me vengaré de lo que hicieron.
Lo logramos, Shabab, fantasma del desierto. Tal como nos ordenaron. Pero me temo que el derramamiento de sangre no ha hecho más que empezar.
Las tropas sublevadas acaban de fusilar al capitán Virgilio Leret Ruiz.
Oh, he got killed? That's not good. Hey, and there you go. Up to the next mission. Alright, time for another video with some Spanish narration.
La Segunda República Española nace con el propósito de aportar soluciones a los problemas que arrastraba la convulsa España de finales del siglo XIX y principios del XX. La concentración de la riqueza, el amplio poder de la Iglesia, el problema catalán o la crisis interna de un ejército con luchas intestinas marcan la andadura de una república amenazada desde el inicio por varios flancos. Las tradicionales dos Españas comienzan entonces nuevos enfrentamientos en base a viejas reivindicaciones. Algunos estamentos eclesiásticos exhortan a la población a prepararse para la nueva cruzada a fin de recuperar lo perdido. El ejército ve cómo el gobierno disminuye sus competencias y privilegios. Las divisiones se reducen de 16 a 8, se cierran academias militares y se pasa el ejército a la jurisdicción civil, anulando el Consejo Supremo de Guerra y Marina. La ley de reforma agraria hace peligrar la estabilidad social ante la gran presión que soportan los grandes terratenientes y, por ende, los jornaleros que muchas veces malvivían a las órdenes de estos. A todos estos conflictos de intereses se le suma el gran descontento popular por la lenta aplicación de las reformas republicanas prometidas, descontento vehiculado en gran parte a través de los levantamientos anarquistas. El gobierno debe además lidiar con la gran inseguridad social generada por los enfrentamientos en las calles entre falangistas, grupos conservadores y extremistas de izquierda. Es en este panorama político cuando se producen varias intentonas golpistas fallidas, que se paralizan temporalmente con la llegada de los conservadores al gobierno republicano. Acabado este bienio conservador, los estamentos hegemónicos como Iglesia, Ejército y terratenientes continúan conspirando contra el gobierno establecido para derrocarlo y hacer prevalecer sus intereses. Las elecciones y el posterior triunfo del Frente Popular de febrero de 1936 prenden la chispa conspirativa. Un grupo de militares rebeldes inicia una serie de reuniones secretas para ejecutar un nuevo golpe militar el día 20 de abril. Pero el complot es finalmente descubierto por el gobierno, con parte de sus altos mandos sediciosos encarcelados, presionados por unos terratenientes que ven como miles de jornaleros toman sus tierras, y enfrentándose a un gobierno compuesto únicamente por fuerzas republicanas, algunos altos mandos insurrectos ejecutan de manera apresurada un nuevo levantamiento. El 18 de julio de 1936 es el día elegido para alzarse contra el gobierno legítimo de la Segunda República Española. La Guerra Civil Española ha comenzado.
All right, here we got some more text explaining the mission. July 17, 1936, rumors of revolts are becoming more intense. Senior military commanders from different detachments are plotting for weeks to rise up against the Republican government. The military jurors have prepared, even the side of the war, on behalf of Franco, are scheduled to occur in the printing sets of representation of the Legion. A loyal against the Republican government has moved to Mella to investigate what the truth is in the rumors of the sedition. So now we're actually playing on the other side, which I think is very cool that it switches between both sides in the war, and it's just the story of the war that's being told. It's the same as, for example, a movie like Gettysburg, where it's the battle that's the main character, and we, you know, see the battle from both sides, and I think more games should do that.
Hola, ¿hay alguien?
And we're women. Women. We're a woman, too.
Baja la voz. Podrían oírnos.
¿Eres Tomás?
Sí, soy yo. Me he retrasado porque he tenido que ocultarme de unos soldados que patrullaban.
Tranquilo. Todavía estamos dentro del tiempo planeado. ¿Cuál es la posición de la base?
Está situada al este. No te resultará difícil llegar. Lo complicado será lograr escapar si te descubren.
Pues entonces no tenemos que preocuparnos por nada. ¿Vienes conmigo?
Yo no te puedo acompañar. No quiero confundirlo a mi familia.
¿Cómo? Demasiado has hecho ya guiándome hasta aquí.
Recuerda, no eres la única que está en contra de los planes de los militares sublevados. Sé de buena tinta que algunos soldados también se oponen al levantamiento. Encuéntralos. Seguro que no dudarán en unirse a tu causa.
Intentaré cumplir sola esta misión, pero no me vendría mal algo de ayuda. Ojalá tuviera.
Alright, here we go. So yeah, we're playing as a female soldier. And of course it's a civil war, so you know, a lot of the females also fought amongst the troops. And it doesn't also feel forced or social justice warrior at all. And again, it's not only these two characters we will play as. We will play as many more different characters, I believe, throughout the campaign, which is, again, very, very cool. So we need... We have two objectives. B is the main one. I can already see that on the thing. This is an invisible wall here. We need to find the reinforcements, as he said. We can complete this alone, but I would like some more men for our cause. Hey, we found some reinforcements. It says find all reinforcements or link to all reinforcements, so there's more. Got some bottles of wine here, some beds. Alright, what are you guys' name? Marcos Moral and Roberto Tebar. Follow me, guys. Let's see if we can find some more reinforcements. Again, a very different feeling mission compared to the previous one. Very cool. There's another tent here. That must also be reinforcements. Alright, I found all the reinforcements. There we go. Two more. Gustavo Aponte and Alberto Ramos. Okay, we're five strong. Let's go, gentlemen. Let's see if these rumors are true. This mission is also called one day earlier or something. So, this might be in the night, early morning of that day. So we might actually be the one that tell Zato to actually investigate. No, we got one more here.
Ya sabéis que mañana será un día especial para todos, especialmente para nuestra gloriosa nación. En la pequeña imprenta de esta base está el germen del cambio por el que España grita pleno. Libraremos a la patria de la influencia comunista. ¡Por España!
¡Por España! ¡Por España!
Those were the guys that we were just playing at.
¿Quién anda?
Not literally, but that side.
Espías. Activad la alarma.
Uh-oh, we got caught. What do we do? What do we do here, Valentine?
Rápido por aquí.
All right, find an escape route. I'm out of here. Oh, everybody's dead. Holy, that's a lot of units. Oh, this is bad. There's someone there. You have an escape route? Gustavo? Oh, there's Valentine. We made it out. Alright, that was a short but sweet mission. Let's continue. Another narration time.
El 18 de julio de 1936 estalla la rebelión. Después de que tropas sublevadas de regulares dominen la plaza de Tetuán, el general Franco aterriza en la ciudad solo un día después a bordo del bimotor de Havilland Dragon Rapid y manda un mensaje al presidente de la República para que entregue el mando. La noticia del alzamiento se extiende rápidamente por todas las capitales españolas. A pesar de que el gobierno informa enseguida por radio a todo el país de que ninguna guarnición peninsular secunda la rebelión del ejército de África, los insurrectos se hacen enseguida con importantes plazas de la España metropolitana como Sevilla, Burgos o Zaragoza. Durante las siguientes jornadas se suceden los enfrentamientos entre fuerzas rebeldes y leales a la República en toda la geografía española. Tras la muerte en accidente de aviación del general Sanjurjo, el liderazgo del bando nacional queda dividido entre las figuras de Franco y Mola, quienes enseguida buscan apoyo internacional. Apenas nueve días después del levantamiento, llega a España el primer escuadrón de aviones italianos enviados por Benito Mussolini en respuesta a estas peticiones, la llamada aviación legionaria. El bando nacional establece como órgano provisional de gobierno la Junta de Defensa Nacional en Burgos. Desde allí se articula el avance de las tropas rebeldes sobre Madrid, tras asegurarse en menos de un mes el control de gran parte del territorio sur español. Aunque la capital de España se ve severamente castigada por los bombardeos, Franco decide aplazar la conquista de Madrid y ordena al general Enrique Varela que abandone la campaña y parta hacia Toledo a liberar el Alcázar.
All right, here we got some more text explaining the situation. It's now September 18th, 1936. We are now in Toledo. The rebels have been locked in the imposing building of the Alcazar Toledo to fail the uprising in Toledo. The military leader of the square, Colonel Moscardo, stoically withstands Republican attacks without giving or supporting even the possibility that militias shoot his son Luis that they captured. It's not really... Again, the creators are also not English natives, so it's sometimes a little bit difficult to read these texts, but I'm trying to translate as much as I can here. The rebel general Varela and his troops tried desperately to free them. The siege of the Alcazar. Oh, now it says July 23rd. That must be Moscardo.
Coronel Moscardo, al aparato. Soy el jefe de los milicianos y seré breve. Si no rinde la fortaleza en 10 minutos, fusilaremos a su hijo Luis.
Quiero hablar con él. Padre, soy yo, Luis.
Hijo mío, encomiéndate a Dios y muere como un hijo.
Eso será fácil. Ambos lo haremos.
Wow, can you imagine that?
¿No vas a acceder a nuestra petición?
Jamás. ¡Viva España!
That you as a father even are willing to sacrifice your son, let him get shot. You're standing your ground with the rebels. And that's cold. Alright, what's my thing? Kill the enemy sniper. Looks like I actually have to go up there in that room. Look at this, this is also really cool. Got some custom textures. It's a little bit transparent there, but it's fine. This whole area looks very unique, very cool. Very unique helmets also these rebels have. And the cool thing is that if you actually watch like historic documentaries about the Civil War, you actually realize that a lot of the, you know, the equipment, the helmets, the weapons, it's all accurate. It's all accurate on how it was. What's happening? Sniper? Where you at? Oh, I saw the, oh, there he is. Huh? Thought I saw him, it was actually a lamppost. Eyes on the roof. Oh, there we go. All right, we're moving. Exit the fortress in search of food. We've, of course, been in this fortress for so long that many of us are starving, so let's send out a patrol to gather some food. And again, in the briefing it says that another general is actually coming this way towards the city in order to free us from this position. So here we go, here we got some urban fighting. And again, as I said before, the Moroccan troops were not actually that good in fighting here. They were not used to this kind of environment. It was a bit too complex and complicated for them, because they were not used to this kind of terrain back home. Again, such a unique feeling to have in Call of Duty 2. Really, really cool. Look at that. It's gorgeous. Oh, there. You can actually see that's the room where we were at just a moment ago. Like, the sniper we killed was right there. You can see his weapon and his body. Okay, we got some cover here. Looks like fighting's gonna happen. Yep. Yep, throw a grenade. Or a Molotov, that's also fine. We got Sergio. With a Sergio knows what to do.
Oh.
So enemies to the left. Absolutely not. Oh god. Oh! Did get killed by that grenade. I thought I actually had him before he could throw that grenade. I don't think I have one, no. Actually got two with one shot there. Did you just throw a Molotov cocktail at me? Oh, another one. Come on, boys. I saw something drop. Yep, that was a grenade. I didn't actually see the indicator. A lot of dudes here. Even be better to switch to sidearm. Not too sure what my teammates are shooting at. Ugh. That should have been a hit. No, come on, stab. There we go. Okay, the melee attack is not very, very impressive. That much is clear. Alright, set up. Oh, I can switch pistols here. Only 3 bullets, no thank you. I also now have a Molotov. Actually, yeah, for door-to-door fighting, might as well switch to the pistol. You with me, Sergio? I need your help. I need your moral support. Looks like there's some food here. And enemy contact. Clear! Can we do something with the food here? It's all empty. Still looking for food. Oh, a lot of grenades. Got them from both sides. Got him. Nice. Okay, teammates are dealing with him. That guy's just crawling away. I'll just let him bleed to death. Nope. I lied. Alright, what you got here? More enemies in the street. Oh. Storm through the fire. And again, this mission is once more so different from the previous ones. Really cool. Oh. Then I was out of ammo. Oh! Might as well now switch to this one. Oh, nice execution, comrade. Oh, looks like we're going down. We're stuck here. Come on, Sergio. Move. Alright, that's the food right there. Let's check if it's clear.
Demasiado tiempo sin dejarse notar.
Dudo que tramen nada bueno esos asesinos.
Oh no.
That's bad.
¡Detrás de ti! ¡Soldados a las armas! ¡Vuelven a atacar!
¡Han abierto brecha en el muro del patio!
¡Rápido! ¡Reforzad las defensas de esa zona!
Okay, repel the waves of enemy attacks. We got 6 waves incoming. We got pistol, regular rifle. Got a lot of teammates here. Let's make it happen, boys. Got a machine gun. I'm just gonna let the AI do the shooting here. If he dies, I'll take over. These helmets here, or hats, are really interesting. I saw them too in the documentary, where, like, they got the vertical flap at the back. Oh, shit. Oh, I gotta reload! Oh, we lost. I never knew his name. Shoot, please! Are you out of ammo? Oh, they're climbing the roof there, too. I'm being pushed back here. We lost the AI on the machine gun. Die! For España! I see, there's no iron sight. Great. I was shooting over his head for quite a while. 3 remaining. And you can throw as many Molotov cocktails as you like. Still got a lot of teammates here. Oh, here they come. They really do like coming through that door. Nice grenade. Killed like 3 guys. Don't you run away from me, boy. Stab you. There we go. 2 remaining. They're coming from the left side now. Left and center. They're coming with a lot now. Jesus. Here. Oh, you're still alive. Nice. One remaining. Final wave incoming, boys. Keep it up. Look at all these piles of bodies. Still got a good amount of AI left. Another grenade. Come on, boys, cover me. Oh, they're bringing out the whole government army here. Actually, I say government army. These are, of course, militias. There we go. That's the final one. Oh, maybe not. Now I understand why it said September earlier, because of course they were in there for almost 2 months. Let's see what it says. Eliminate the artillery docks, 4 remaining. So now we're fighting again as the Moroccan forces coming in from the outside. Let's save our comrades that are stuck in the Alcazar. I wish we had Merciless Ali with us. He died too young. Oh, that grenade went way too far. Lost one of our own. One remaining. There's still a lot left, sir. Oh, what is this? That's interesting. Finally, a fast, rapid weapon. Feels a bit like a pea shooter, but I'm not complaining. Also, that was an incredible kill where I did not even point at the enemy and I still killed him. Just gathering some ammo for it. Alright. Free the fortress. Well, there's the city. That's it right there. This is the artillery that was, of course, bombarding it during the cutscene. We check that out. I hope by now, also, you're starting to understand the scope of this mod. Where, you know, some creators have maybe one or two missions. Ah, we were with Jesus! You know, one or two missions for the game. And this one is a whole campaign. I'm not kidding. For a moment there, I thought that those were friendly units. The kickback on this thing is pretty big. There we go. Oh no, Jesus the killer! Don't go too far ahead, Jesus. I will shoot you. I heard a grenade. No, you don't. What are you gonna do with this guy, Jesus?
Eso va a doler.
That's Jesus for you there. This is where we were earlier, wasn't it? Yeah, exactly. We were fighting right over there. At those stairs. I'm almost out of ammo. Don't tell me we lost Jesus. Nope. Still there. All right. Set forward. Well, we kind of know the way now, I guess, if we go back this way. Oh, no, this door's now closed. Looks like we have to go by the main street. Yeah, it's right there. Uh-oh. I hear a tank. Destroy the armored, oh god, with a sticky bomb. Oh, that's easier said than done. It was right my chance when it drove by, but I have to get close to it. Oh! Thank you, Jesus. Gracias. One thing that I think also is super, super cool, because this is all, you know, 1936, a lot of the weapons and armor is still very, you know, very early tech. You know, this is not a mod where you will see Shermans or, you know, Tiger tanks, because they didn't exist yet. Right there. That's not an ideal location for me. There it is. No, don't you drive away from me, boy. There we go. All right, we're on the move again. Did we lose Jesus? Nope, still there. Oh, oh my God. These are all the guys I killed earlier. Look at this pile. Oh my goodness. Well, anyway, good news, guys. We're here. We're here to free you guys. Come on. Where's Moscardo at? He's on the bottom floor, isn't he?
Señor, nosotros somos solo la vanguardia. El grueso del ejército está en camino.
Estamos al límite de nuestras fuerzas, pero aguantaremos.
Oh God. Defend the fortress until the reinforcements arrive. 3.5 minutes. We can do that. Looks like I'm on a machine gun again. Here they come! That pile's not big enough. More militia can join it. Oh, Don't walk in front of the machine gunner. That's a life lesson there. This guy immediately ignored that. It's Jesus! Jesus! The rascal. He knows no fear. He's like, screw your machine gun. I walk right in front of it. Actually, he's shooting. Oh, shit. Hang on, Jesus. We came all the way here. We're not gonna let this militia stop us. How we're doing? See, it's sometimes difficult because we also have guys in blue. We have these guys. It sometimes be a little bit confusing on who's who. Less than 2 minutes. Shit! Grenade! I do have a grenade. And a Molotov. Right side! Oh no. Put the explosive in the armored car. Oh, and the car's now shooting. Oh boy. Okay, how are we gonna do this? I don't know if that's optional. Let's try. There you go. Happy hunting. Oh my god. Oh Jesus. Jesus, protect me!
Recargando.
God, I'm trying to kill this dude for a very long time. There's like three people over there. Alright, reinforcements should arrive any moment. Stuck. I'm stuck. Are they trying to run? We won't let you. Might actually have to clean all this up. Pick up the national flag. Remove the communist flag. All right, over there. Gotta get to the second floor. There's still enemies there. I kinda wish I had a SMG type weapon here. There we go. Viva España! He tried to run. We will not let you. And what a slaughter, people. Oh my goodness. Oh, here they come. Hey! Join the battle, brothers. Your sighting is most welcome. Without incident at Alcazar. It's another narration time.
El 18 de julio de 1936 estalla la rebelión. Las fuerzas rebeldes se hacen en apenas unos días con plazas como la de Marruecos, las Islas Canarias, Galicia, León y algunas de las ciudades andaluzas más grandes. A pesar de ello, el golpe de Estado es un fracaso. Las fuerzas republicanas sofocan sin miramientos los motines de las principales zonas industrializadas como Madrid o Barcelona. Los insurrectos no han conseguido acabar de un golpe con el poder de la República y apenas controlan un tercio del territorio español. Ambos bandos se preparan para un largo conflicto que ha de durar años. No obstante, el levantamiento deja dislocados los aparatos de gobierno del Estado. Tras un primer acercamiento por parte del gobierno republicano para pactar con los rebeldes, el nuevo gabinete de José Giral entrega armas a las distintas fuerzas sociales de izquierdas. Improvisadas milicias integradas por fuerzas anarquistas, socialistas y comunistas se encargan de sofocar la rebelión en diversos territorios. Aún así, los sublevados consiguen trasladar gran parte de sus tropas desde Marruecos a territorio peninsular por vía aérea, a pesar del férreo control inicial de la República del Estrecho. En ese sentido, la ayuda de los aviones enviados por Mussolini y Hitler a los sublevados es decisiva. Las tropas leales han de verse las caras con la columna de soldados rebeldes que avanza desde el sur, tomando a su paso importantes enclaves como Badajoz o Talavera, en su camino hacia Madrid. Pero antes de llegar a la capital de España, los nacionales reciben órdenes de desviarse hacia Toledo. Sus intenciones son claras: liberar la ciudad y socorrer a la guarnición nacional que está sitiada por milicias republicanas.
Alright, here we got some text again. The loyal troops of the militiamen take days harassing the national troops that, after the failure of his rebellion, had taken a refuge in the fortress. The sights are exhausted and desperate, but resist beyond the expected by Republican forces. The besiegers decided to end the siege once and for all. The aerial bombardments to multiply and begin to dig two mines under the fortress. The aim of these excavations is clear: to blow tons of explosives to tear down the building and take the Alcazar before reinforcements arrive. So now we're actually doing the same battle again, but now from the communist side.
Turbi!
That might have actually been the explosion that we saw that actually sunk that one tower of the building. Here comes CNT, which actually I read this is a syndicalist origins. Very interesting.
Ni un paso atrás.
This is where we shot up the artillery before, so this is actually before that.
Vivir tiempos difíciles, camaradas. Tiempos en los que debemos sacrificar hasta lo más preciado por la libertad de nuestro país. La toma del Alcázar es una espina que todavía no hemos conseguido arrancarnos. Y cada día que pasa, se hunde más en la herida. Mario, tú dirigirás un grupo que avanzará por la parte este del Alcázar, mientras otro escuadrón atacará por el oeste.
Sí, señor. Tomaremos la fortaleza y demostraremos a esos fascistas quiénes somos.
I cannot believe that actually, if you take the fortress, you're able to resist it so long, even with aerial bombardments, artillery. Yeah, look at that. These guys are all about to die in a moment when Franco's reinforcements arrive. Good luck, comrades. Rain down hell on those fascists. May you live long and prosper.
We know they won't.
Alright. Comrades. Oh, look at that. We got some female comrades as well. We got Adriana. Gregorio. Juan. Pablo. Let's go.
Stay close to me.
Go to the cannon, press. Oh, I can even use some artillery. Not too sure if this is the most effective way to do this on like a bridge. I'm not at a great angle here. Well, I killed that guy. Alright, we got a very large force though. There's the building. Everybody move, 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 move! Capture this bridge. Go. The grenade. Oh! I forgot that they sidestep so much in Call of Duty 2. It's really good. Makes them sometimes pretty difficult to hit. Alright. Execute anyone who's still alive. These two are still alive. No one's gonna... Well, no one's gonna care about you too, so... I will shorten your suffering. No mercy for these fascists. And again, to me, it's so cool that, you know, the one moment I'm fighting for the one side and the other for the other, so... I don't know. We let the battle speak for itself. And history in that regard.
Mi general. Las tropas de Marion Barrena han conseguido cruzar el puente y penetrar en el perímetro de la fortaleza.
Nuestros camaradas también han logrado abrirse camino por el flanco oeste. Informe a Marion de los avances del segundo grupo y ordénele que se reúna con ellos para evacuar toda la resistencia dentro del país.
Esta fortaleza es inexpugnable, general. No podemos hacer nada contra esos gruesos muros.
Camarada Barrena, nuestra división de ingenieros lleva tiempo trabajando en un plan para tomar la fortaleza. Hemos comenzado la construcción de varios túneles desde los que haremos estallar una gran cantidad de explosivo para abrir brecha a las defensas del edificio.
Enseguida, mi general, volaremos ese maldito castillo en mil pedazos.
All right, so let's go to those tunnels then. Are you okay, Miguel? You seem to have a little bit of an issue there. This is, of course, the square that we battled moments earlier that in this story has not happened yet. I wonder if chronologically it would have been better to actually first have the first part of the previous mission, then have you play this part, and then, after that, the final part where you play as the Moroccan soldiers as you come in to retrieve the man from the fortress. Because again, we're now kind of going back in time. Which again, I really do like that we see both perspectives. But we do kind of know what's happening. Makes you wonder if you like a Let's Play where you do the missions in chronological order in terms of like story would be quite cool. This is where we found the food. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a tunnel route, right? To the end of the tunnel. Will do. Nope. This tunnel are invaded by fascists. Let's root them out. Like rats. For communism! full of syndicalism. Oh. Okay, I have to protect him. Great. I have one grenade. He actually shot the other guy. There we go. Alright, stay close. Oh, that's a friendly one. Oh, it's another Jesus. Oh. We're doing protects while placing dynamite. There we go. Get to a safe distance. Alright, that's it. Come on, Jesus, this is gonna blow. Hurry up. Let her rip. Yep, exactly. That's what we saw earlier. So that was our doing. Very cool. See how like all these stories sort of like intermingle? It's very well written in that regard. Very, very well done. Get to the fortress. Come on, comrades! We just blew up the tower. Let's go and capture that fortress. Oh, you see them all running already. For the Republic! For the government! Death to the fascists! Oh, now we're going to be the... We're going to be the wave that attacks the fortress. I wonder if... Well, the Moroccan forces haven't met yet. But yeah, look, there's an NPC on the machine gunner. So we... I am the one... Bam! That killed the NPC on a machine gun. Protect the militia to put up the flag. Oh, that's what we're gonna do now. Okay. Where's the militia with the flag? There you are. Alright, stay with me, buddy. I'll give you cover. Communism! Resist in the fortress. Not entirely sure what that means, but I'm probably attack. Because we know we cannot capture this, but I assume that we just have to Oops. It's fine too. Just have to do as much damage. Job. Not too sure if they keep spawning. We'll try to move inward. They're on the second floor too. We still have a lot of NPCs on our side though. Come on, comrades! Push! There we go. Good kill. Oh, got a hit. Almost there. Got quiet. Objective completed.
Oh,
that's us. That's
no
the Moroccan troops.
Ahora. Jamás.
Parada Barrena. El general Rojo ha ordenado que abandone la misión. No tenemos ninguna posibilidad contra el contingente franquista.
No. Hemos sufrido demasiado hasta llegar hasta aquí para abandonar ahora.
Es una orden, camarada. Acuérdela. Tendrá un consejo de guerra.
Maldición. No nos queda otra opción. ¡Retirada, camaradas! ¡Retirada!
Oh, here they come. Here they come. They are being executed by Franco's forces. All right, next mission. No narration this time. Cartagena, September 21st, 1936. The Republican government approves the transfer of a major operation. This is nothing less than to carry much of the gold reserves of the Bank of Spain to the Soviet Union. The USSR to the Republic cause the convoy of trucks carrying gold is routed to the port of Cartagena, where they will leave the gold in a natural refuge. Once there, the plan is that after a month, four Soviet freighters carrying the precious load until Soviet lands. But the convoy will find many difficulties on the road. Alright, that's very interesting. So the government actually put its gold to the Soviet Union.
Halcón 1. Es de vital importancia que el convoy no sufra ningún daño.
Recibido. De momento no detecto actividad enemiga. Espere un momento. Creo... ¡Maldita sea! ¡Tiene antiaéreo!
Oh.
Debo encontrar esos malditos camiones antes de que los fascistas me den caza.
Oh, we gotta crash one. Locate the convoy Republican. So we're still fighting for the government. We haven't switched side yet. Only armed with a pistol now. Friend or foe? Jesús.
Al fin les encuentro. Soy el piloto Félix Breznev y he sido derribado por esos facciosos mientras escoltaba el convoy en mi avión.
Oh, your name's Felix?
Mucha suerte, hijo.
Not Jesús.
No sabía que en esta misión dispondríamos de apoyo aéreo.
Las órdenes que recibí eran escoltaros hasta la playa. ¿Se puede saber qué es eso tan valioso que transportáis?
Es alto secreto, camarada. Ni yo mismo.
Oh, no, my name is Felix.
Señor, hemos localizado tropas rebeldes en nuestra retaguardia. Si no avanzamos, nos alcanzarán en pocos minutos.
¡Malditos fascistas!
Debemos partir hacia el objetivo a toda costa. No tenemos tiempo que perder.
Está bien, camarada Félix. ¡En marcha!
Leave it to me. Oh, look at that. We got like a truck turret section, like you have in the regular Call of Duties as well. Oh, nice. Now we got some firepower. Ready when you are, Jesus. Here we go. I'll kill any fascists, any rebels that come our way. That's the gold right there. Nothing in this truck. I'm just the bodyguard. Oh. Already. They're a little bit far. I need to accurately hit them with this weapon. Another truck. Fine, we lost them. Oh wow, I'm running out of ammo for these things very quickly. go. All right, crossing the bridge. Okay, they crashed. Oh, we got a big group coming. Grenade? Hell no, that you're gonna throw a grenade. That guy was limping. Get a truck, escort, convoy to port. Alright, they're rolling the bridge. Good, good, good. Let's move. Andale, andale. Uh-oh, more incoming. I think I already got a few of them. Another truck ahead. It's gonna be difficult for me to hit. We're at the water though. We're at the coast, so hopefully we're soon at the port. He just drove over that cliff. Alright. I don't have to worry about that one. Oh, and they're driving off the cliff as well. Yep, there they go. Hey, we did it. Long live the CNT. See, it's super cool that they actually also have a mission like this. I mean, this mod has it all. I cannot praise this mod enough. More story in Spanish.
Las avanzadillas del rebelde general Varela consiguen liberar a los sitiados en el Alcázar de Toledo. La noticia conmueve al mundo y el bando nacional se apunta a un gran tanto propagandístico a nivel internacional. El ejército rebelde reemprende de esta manera su marcha para tomar Madrid. Después de una sucesión de cambios en el Ejecutivo, el nuevo jefe del gobierno republicano Francisco Largo Caballero consigue un gobierno de unidad integrado por socialistas, comunistas y grupos nacionalistas vascos y catalanes. Largo Caballero consigue también el respaldo ideológico y logístico por parte de la Unión Soviética. Entre otros, esto se traduce en el envío de aviones Polikarpov I-15, conocidos como Chatos, e I-16, también llamados Moscas. Al igual que los tanques T-26, también rusos, todas estas máquinas resultaban superiores a sus contrapartidas alemanas e italianas. Pero no solo la Unión Soviética se interesa en defender la legitimidad del gobierno republicano. El bando leal cuenta también con las simpatías de muchos voluntarios antifascistas a nivel internacional. Numerosos exiliados alemanes, italianos, franceses, polacos, checos y de otras muchas nacionalidades luchan contra el avance del fascismo europeo desde las filas republicanas. Estas tropas constituyen el germen de lo que en un futuro se conocerán como las Brigadas Internacionales. El imparable avance nacional hacia la capital de España desde el sur hace imprescindible la colaboración de todos los efectivos posibles. Al grito de "no pasarán", todos los madrileños se movilizan y miles de milicianos salen de la ciudad para contener el avance de las vanguardias marroquíes.
All right, we are finally here in Madrid, November 7th, 1936, still in the first year of the Three-Year War. So, we can all probably guess what's going to happen in the capital here. The city of Madrid begins to suffer the first air raids. Its important and strategic position, and the population loyal strive to dig trenches and barricades to prevent the rebel advance. The Madrid metro units are revealed as magnificent bunkers. The Republican troops should ensure that civilians are safe from bombing while resisting successive attacks by land. That's the air raid alarm. Let's get all the civilians to the metro. Come on, everybody to the metro.
Oh.
No pasarán. They shall not pass. There's the air raids.
Esos aviones fascistas no presagian nada bueno.
Miserables. Siempre lanzan bombardeos de castigo antes de cada nueva ofensiva.
Ordena que refuercen todas las defensas.
Se presenta el capitán Guzmán. Desde el cuartel general, ordenan enlazar con la columna de Ortega.
Enseguida, yo me encargo de esto. Necesitaré a 4 de los mejores hombres de la columna de Urruti.
¡Eso está hecho!
All right, we need to regroup with Ortega's men. Now we need to cover the process. These are the 4 men. Let's cover them.
Adelante, yo lo cubriré.
Here we go.
Carga!
En marcha.
Nice kill. There we go. Ooh, God.
Rápido, rápido.
All right, let's advance. Ah, look at that. Evacuate Madrid. Again, I love all of the custom posters, the custom textures. It's just, it's so great. It's rough around the edges in some places, I'll give it that. But in terms of, like, mods for first-person games, I think this is absolutely in the top. It deserves it. Just for the amount of content, the effort, the details. Oh, God. It's actually, if you're Spanish, you kind of owe it to yourself to play this. This is part of your history right here. It's a setting that gets ignored so much in pop culture, like video games or movies. You know, there are so many movies about the World War, or World War II, because Spain had its own conflict before and during that. They don't really pay a lot of attention to it. We're slowly inching our way forward. Do I have a grenade? I do. Let's take out that machine gun nest. That guy's trying to crawl away. Good luck with that. No, he got pretty far, but in the end, it didn't even matter. It actually not also makes sense that we are using Russian weaponry, as we are of course now more hand in hand with the Soviets. I think also the Soviets are sending a lot of volunteers our way to help us. Both are though. Wait, is that a? No. Both are, though, since, of course, the rebels are fascist. They will get help from Italy and Germany.
Soldado, registre esa tanqueta. Parece que ha sido destruida recientemente.
Mario, he encontrado una carpeta con documentos.
Déjame verlos.
What do we got here?
Parecen órdenes de un potente ataque enemigo. Y está previsto para hoy mismo. Rápido, lleva estos documentos al general Miaja. Los fascistas tienen planeado atacar la ciudad en media hora.
Sí, señor.
Let's go. The air raids were just the beginning. The main attack is still to come. I mean, just look at this. This is so awesome.
Comandante Ortega, traigo un mensaje del cuartel general.
Gracias. Llevamos bastante tiempo aislados.
Toda la ciudad de Madrid lleva demasiado tiempo aislada por culpa de esos fascistas.
Así es. Antes de que te marches, necesito pedirte un último favor.
Si está en mi mano, lo haré con gusto, mi comandante.
El fuego enemigo obligó a este grupo de civiles a refugiarse entre nosotros. Pero no podemos escoltarlos hasta un lugar seguro, porque debemos mantener esta posición.
Comprendo. Les guiaré hasta una boca de metro que estamos usando como refugio.
Comprende.
Mario, las tropas de Franco se acercan a nuestra base. Parece que han adelantado el ataque.
¡Maldición! Antes deberíamos poner a salvo a estos civiles.
Buena suerte, camarada.
All right, here we go. Let's get the people to safety. Then dig in. Wait for the rebels. Our Madrid will not fall. They shall not pass.
Rápido, por aquí. Quedaos ahí abajo y no salgáis hasta que paren los bombardeos.
Muchas gracias. No sé cómo pagártelo.
I actually really like that it has cutscenes as well. I realize that the animations...
No pasarán.
No pasarán. Exactly. Right. I realize that the animations and the cutscenes aren't anything special, maybe even a little bit rough. But again, the fact that they have cutscenes, which the regular campaign does not, is really cool. Wait for me, dude! Roberto, wait for me! You're gonna fight the war without me? Oh god, the shelling has started! Ugh. We all know what comes after the first artillery strikes. That's when the waves of infantry come.
Ahí llegan esos criminales! ¡No cedáis ni un metro!
Nuestro gobierno sí que ha cedido. Huyen a Valencia, nos abandonan ante...
¡Here they come!
Camarada, no podemos avanzar nuestra libertad. Además, su matriz
existirá. ¡No pasará el suelo! ¡No pasarán!
¡No pasarán! That guy's rushing. Grenade! I don't have a lot of ammo left. Might have to switch to a rebel weapon. Oh god! Alright, I need to back up. I need to be with my buddy Juan. Just always looking at how many bodies there are left after a battle. It's just... Oh god, grenade. This is staggering. Why does modern Call of Duty does not have this epicness anymore? I don't get it. Okay, they're retreating. Move with your comrades to the trenches.
Follow the flag! For communism!
This weapon has also a lot of kickback. I saw that grenade. Move another grenade. Oh, damn. Ugh. That got me. Oh my god, there are so many. Let's actually try it from this angle now. Let's take our time with this. Oh. They have machine guns at the next sandbag line. Might actually be a trench. Be careful, flag bearer. You're here to keep morale up. That's great, comrade. You've got one. Let's continue. Bring me all the heads of all the fascists. We lost a female soldier. Oh, Jesus. Yep, I'm going around. No mercy. Kill them all. Oh, is that it? Move through the trenches. We need to go further. Oh, look at that. We got some tanks as well. These look like ours, though. Okay, here we go. Repel four waves. All right, here we go. Don't have a whole lot of ammo for four waves, but we'll see. Do still have a grenade. Nice. I actually got him. That guy crawled right into a grenade. That was amazing. Oh, is that the next wave? Nope. Okay, that's one wave down. Three more. Oh god, we lost the flag bearer. Or are you just scared? No, he's dead. Don't give in to fear, comrades! The flag bearer might be dead, but communism will live on. Syndicalism. Whatever. I have some of that ammo. Can I get it? Oh, there's an invisible wall here. Ugh, get back in. Okay, well, I cannot get that. That means I even have less ammo than I first thought. Alright. Another wave down. Lost another comrade. They're trying to spread out and flank. Yep, exactly. Get him at the side. Oh, Oh, I got two with one. Nice. Nice, got him. All right, final wave. We're doing good. Still got enough ammo. Oh, they're being aggressive here. They're rushing. Shit, he threw a grenade. Mercedes. Always found Mercedes a very beautiful name for a girl. Losing so many female comrades. This is the final wave. Soon. Yes, there we go. We got it. We still hold Madrid, fellow comrades. Oh, here comes a tank of ours. Oh, and a tank of theirs. Take it out. It's a T-26. More narration.
El grueso del ejército de África, fundamental para los propósitos rebeldes, se encuentra todavía en territorio marroquí. Puestos a impedir el paso de estas tropas, la flota republicana decide bloquear el estrecho de Gibraltar. El resultado es que solo consigue llegar a territorio peninsular una columna rebelde formada por apenas 1,000 hombres. Pero el férreo control republicano del estrecho se ve menguado cuando el alto mando decide retirar sus efectivos para cubrir el avance de las tropas rebeldes en el norte de España. Esta coyuntura, unida al hecho de que dos potentes cruceros nacionales se unen al ataque rebelde en el estrecho, deja vía libre a las fuerzas del ejército de África para entrar en territorio español. Mientras, en el norte, la aviación rebelde apoyada por aviones Junkers alemanes bombardea importantes emplazamientos republicanos como Irún o San Sebastián durante el mes de agosto. El cerco de las fuerzas nacionales se va estrechando hasta que finalmente los bastiones republicanos quedan rodeados por tierra a finales de septiembre. A principios de octubre, Franco es nombrado jefe del gobierno del Estado español por la Junta Técnica del Estado, adoptando además el título de jefe del Estado y generalísimo de los ejércitos. El también llamado caudillo, como le empieza a denominar la maquinaria propagandística nacional, inicia la campaña de la toma de Madrid, apoyado por, entre otros, los muy superiores carros alemanes Panzer I o las vanguardias marroquíes que avanzan desde Extremadura.
All right, everybody, here we have some more text explaining this next mission. We are Madrid, November 13th, 1936. Once conquered, the neighboring towns of Mostoles, Leganés, and Getafe start the rebel siege of the capital. Thousands of militants emerging from Madrid to try to stem the advance of the rebel troops, shouting, "You shall not pass." Upon arrival of the reinforcements, the Legion Condor, the strategy of the rebels going to take the hill Garabitas, coinciding with the start of hostilities in the sky between fighters. All right.
Debemos encontrar un lugar seguro y esperar a que lleguen los refuerzos.
Yo buscar sitio. Yo buen explorador. Palabra.
Adelante, camaradas.
All right, now we're playing on the side of the rebels again. Time to get some communist pigs.
En marcha.
Not fighting as a Moroccan troop this time, though. They're on our side. Here we go. Nice grenade. Oh, he's throwing grenades as well. Be careful. All right, move forward. Yeah, sucks to be you.
Get
¡Atención! ¡Fuego de cobertura!
Did we lose anyone? Sound like one of our team got hit. Doesn't look like it. Oh! That asks for a grenade. Oh! We just lost someone. Those are the fighter planes they were talking about. Alright, we're going over this. Come on, you can do it. There you go. This guy's trying to crawl through the bushes. We won't let him. Death to the communists. Oh god. What happened here? We need to find a safe place.
Aquí base, encontrada fortaleza buena. Muy seguro.
Buen trabajo. Pensaba que no volveríamos a verte. Este sitio es perfecto.
Yo encontrar granja cerca.
Perfecto. Iré allí para hablar con el granjero. Me aseguraré de que ofrece de buen grado parte de su cosecha a nuestra causa.
Find the farm. Oh! Well, I just broke his fence.
La producción de esta granja servirá para aumentar nuestros recursos.
Oh, here we go. Oh, we got Germans here with us now.
Señor, había un alemán caído. Necesitan ayuda. Tener soldados alemanes.
Hi. Nuestro jefe de escuadra, Alfred von Richthofen, ha sido abatido cerca. Debemos ir a rescatarle enseguida.
Cobardes. Han temido de ser los antiaéreos. Ya veremos si son tan valientes combatiendo las distancias cortas. Vamos, tenemos que rescatar a nuestros hermanos alemanes de la Legión Cóndor.
The Cóndor Legion.
Granada, a cubierto.
I wish the it's very clear that the German guy is also done by a Spanish person. I wish it was done by an actual German person, but I guess that's a bit more difficult to ask for a small mob team. Oh! Molotov right on my butt. Invisible wall here. You know what? I can return the favor. There you go. Alright, inside, inside! Is he actually fighting with us, the German soldier? He is. Oh! Communist swine! Man, they're getting aggressive here. It's about to shoot him. Some of the uniforms actually do look alike because, of course, it is a civil war, so there's not super clear sides in terms of armor or uniforms.
5 days sin agua.
Are those hours? Crap. Go. I have a Molotov. There you go, boys. My treat. Oh, four guys with them. These guys look new. They have a patch on their arm. Not too sure what they're from. Are these also international soldiers? We got Enfields. Are these supposed to be British? Or Irish? I know that the Irish actually fought with one side quite a bit. We'll figure it out. Let me go here. See, again, the Germans are now actually on our side, on the nationalist side. Oh. For those planes. But the Soviets are helping the other... Oh, crap. It was a little overkill with the grenade, but sure. Let's follow Kessler. Retrieve the members of the Legion Condor. We're looking for the down plane. It's here, right? Yeah. Hey, guys. We got Koch, Reiter, Meyer, Schumann, Baumann, Jäger, Hahn und Bergmann.
Ferrichtofen, estamos atrapados. Dos búnkeres servidos cortan el único camino de salida.
Siva, malditos comunistas. Cargaos de los heridos y estad listos. Nuestros aliados no tardarán mucho en venir a recogernos. Gracias por liberarnos, soldado. El Führer sabrá recompensaros.
Mi única recompensa es acabar con esa escoria roja y ver Madrid rendida ante nosotros.
No nos será tarea fácil tomar la ciudad. Mientras la sobrevolaba, pude comprobar que está rodeada de búnkeres y antiaéreos.
Nuestro plan era esperar a los refuerzos para tomar la base enemiga del Cerro Garavitas, pero parece que finalmente no han llegado.
Nosotros somos los refuerzos. ¿No te parecemos suficientes?
Creía que vendrían más hombres.
¿Más? Un soldado alemán vale al menos por 5 soldados de cualquier ejército. Además, si no me equivoco, nos enfrentamos a civiles con rifles y uniformes improvisados.
Well, he's not wrong about the uniforms.
Basta está hecho cada uno en el campo de batalla.
Okay, so again, this is what I'm talking about. So they were clearly talking to each other, and they're German. So again, it would have been nice if they were speaking German, but again, that might be more difficult to find. Like, if I were to make something where there's a Spanish character, I don't have any Spanish-speaking male friends. So I would have to, like... Oh, is that enemy? Did we just lose von Richthofen?
Acaben con ellos!
Also, he said one German is worth 5 guys in a thing. This guy gets shot immediately. Oh, that guy's still alive. He's gonna die horribly. Okay, no, von Richthofen is still here. Doing here, take the hill Garavitas. Are we going through the door here? What's the plan? Let's kill the red scum. Oh, they have a machine gun of some sort. Oh, that was a mistake. Yep. I did not think there were that many in the trench over there. Crap. I do think I got a few of them in French. I'm going for it. There we go. Some good kills in there. Alright, you guys can move up if you want. Come on, boys. I don't know what this guy wants. How many units did we lose? Is that Kessler? Did we lose Kessler? Well, we got von Richthofen again. Or still. But all his German soldiers that are worth 5 men on the battlefield are gone. Oh! Bitch! Stupid communist plane. Regroup with von Richthofen.
Ha sido realmente sencillo para un auténtico soldado alemán como yo. ¿Qué te ha parecido,
español? No cantes victoria tan pronto. Todavía tenemos que entrar en la ciudad.
¿Tienes algún plan?
Si queremos asaltar con éxito la ciudad, tenemos que hacernos fuertes en esta posición. El alto mando ha planeado llegar al cuartel de la montaña a través de la casa de campo. Y necesitamos abrir una brecha en su defensa para introducir un grupo de soldados que ataquen desde retaguardia.
Con 30 hombres tendremos suficiente.
¿Solo 30? Reclutaremos y entrenaremos a más de 100 si hace falta.
Ni hablar. Yo entrenaré a esos hombres personalmente. Conseguiré hacer que luchen como auténticos soldados alemanes.
Man, he's very secure, very sure about that German efficiency when it comes to soldiers, but in this mod I still have to see it. Oh god. What do we do here? Destroy the anti-tank with the anti-tank gun. Can I get past it? I was out of ammo. Come on, boys, get out of there. Our tank's destroyed as well. It's better than nothing. Oh, we got a lot of soldiers here. Oh, they have a machine gun too. Too far. Still too far. Another runner. Shit. There we go. Oh my god, look how many there are. We're gonna spread out here. More incoming. We're still getting attacked from the back, but shouldn't be too bad. Clear this up. Oh, I can do that back to you, bitch. Alright, that should be it. Hey! We won! Alright guys, here we have the next mission and its text. Madrid, November 15, 1936. The front of Madrid has been established in the Casa del Campo. Although the rebel forces have managed to gain ground, Sancio's column have been besieged. It's envisioned that it will help arrived to column of the Baron and Delgado with its forces together again. The national strategy must go through to make the university city. Now it's November 16th, actually, near the river Manzanares. Presto. We're getting help from the Italians. Are we now actually playing as the Italians? Albertini. I think so. Francesco. It's a little difficult. I think we're now Italians. Per questo siamo venuti. Pronto tutto. Pronto. Yeah. Should be. That's cool. Again, very, very cool that you see from so many perspectives. We have enemies. They had the same idea as I had. More reinforcements, come on. There we go. Machine gun's been taken out. Again, as I said, so incredibly cool that you were playing as so many different sides, different factions, all around the same conflict. This is honestly what we need in more mainstream shooters.
Reunámonos rápidamente con las tropas de Asensio.
And I would say also, again, let the battle be the main character. So we're going in chronological order, and we just switch. Not like Battlefield does it, where you have different short campaigns with the guys. Oh, wow, we are getting slaughtered here. We are, of course, now currently still fighting for the nationalists. The fascists in this case, of course, with the Italian, with Mussolini. Oh, got two. They're both not dead, but... Very cool, too, that a lot of these units now have different skins and models. Because, again, you would think you might have, you know, be fighting, since it's a mod, you would be fighting against the four or five different skins the entire time. And that's not the case. I actually have a grenade as well. I'm running out of ammo. I might actually have to switch to, oh, it is a British. He had a British flag on his arm. That's why they have Lee Enfields. Again, that's the only thing, is that with everybody speaking Spanish, it's a little difficult to... oh, here we go. We got some reinforcements. You guys are most welcome. These are the Spanish again.
Aquí nos tiene, señor. Me he atravesado enjambres de balas silbantes con sumo gusto para llegar hasta usted.
Les esperábamos con impaciencia. Esa zona es vital para los republicanos y estará fuertemente protegida. Vaya con cuidado.
Vaya descorchando el champán, señor. Su hombre más corajoso le dará la victoria.
All right, here we go. Take the School of Architecture. Oh, we have, look at that. We have multiple objectives here. Here they come. Gonna wait for a little bit of reinforcements. The Italians and the Spanish. And the Moroccans. All fighting hand in hand. Nope. They have a tank. Multiple ones. Oh, they're on top of the gate. Got some units with some SMGs as well. It looks like you can shoot through that, but the game does not allow it. There we go. Still a bit too hot to actually enter the place. Yeah, so you cannot shoot through that. Come on. Now we can actually look at it. Yeah, see, it's supposed to be the British. Very interesting. This actually counts as one of the objectives. Some of the Italians are dressed also in black, making them quite difficult to distinguish sometimes from some of these British troops. Apparently there's still an enemy alive because we have not secured objective A yet. Oh. What is this? Oh, that's the Italian, yeah. Oh, this guy we missed. There we go. All right, we got A.
¿Por qué esperar?
Up to the next one. Let's just do it in chronological order. Let's go for B first. Looks pretty different. This actually doesn't look too different from my university back in Holland. Is that one of ours already in the building? There too. Boom, got him. Any more? Still got ammo. Yep, we got another volunteer. Oh, there is one of ours inside. Good. Ammo, got a grenade. Alright, here we can enter. Just checking. Yep, exactly the first floor. See if it's clear. Oh, Jesus. This is actually where I could use a pistol. Over. Hold on. I would prefer one with more than two bullets. Nope. That's the wrong weapon. With a communist gun for a moment, but alright guys, how's it looking here? Any more dead rats?
Hombre herido!
Oh, I see, the Brits have the revolver. Oh, he actually has a lot of bullets. It's good. Something here? All right, we're moving.
Bel lavoro di squadra.
Di squadra. Bellissimo. Come on, Valente. I have both a Molotov and a grenade. Jesus.
Sono sotto il fuoco nemico.
I cannot see through the fire. Okay, we got B. Good, good, good. One final obstacle. Shot him in the back, not very honorable, but all is fair in love and war. Oh, they have a very secure setup there. Nope, too far. I don't know what a good attack angle is here. Oh, what the hell? That is the worst time to find out that I have no ammo. They're actually getting reinforced too. As long as they stay off that machine gun, it's doable. Alright. Take the hospital, Clinico. You got it. Medical ward. Here we go. Wish I could have a bit more ammo again. For indoor fighting, a pistol is much, much more appreciated. Nice, nice kill. Here we go. Executed.
Bel lavoro di squadra.
Clear right. Clear left. No, no grenade. You're gonna blow yourself up if you do that. Regroup with Asensio. Wait, what? Let's take the hospital first, I guess.
Están dentro!
Oh, up there too. Oh, ladder. Oh my god, we're up here with a lot of units.
Bel lavoro di squadra.
Libraos de vuestros canallescos dirigentes que siempre os engañaron y ahora os abandonan. Sabemos quiénes son los culpables y solamente sobre ellos caerá el peso de la ley.
Let's move forward.
Un solo grito ha de unirnos. Viva España.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Only one though. Waste of a grenade. Oh, that's where I should have used my grenade. Beautiful. Let's see if they know how to do the grenade. He can't really run. Oh, he threw it away. Oh, there we go. It exploded before he could. Maybe kill him, El Fuerte. What are you doing?
Atención, madrileños. Llegadas las fuerzas nacionales a las puertas del corazón de Madrid y rebasados los extremos del sur del Manzanares, al persistir la resistencia, se convierte toda la población en un objetivo militar y campo de batalla.
Oh, this is a good angle to actually sneak up on him. See, this is also one of those sort of like, it looks like you can shoot through that fence, but you cannot. It's a solid thing.
Una granada, al riparo!
Granada, salgan de aquí!
All these guys are using pistols. I should have switched to the pistol or to the revolver a long time ago. Yeah, whatever. Objective markers that way, but we'll see.
Voy a lanzar una granada.
Screw your grenade, dude.
Sono armato fino ai denti.
Alright, now what? Regroup with Asensio again. Let's see. Ben. Sticky bombs. We got three tanks. Move! Whoa! Maybe not.
Come on, come on. Go, 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 go.
Oh! I was almost there! Okay, there we go. That's one tank down. Oh, don't come near me, though. Tag down. Good one here. This guy is completely ignoring. Oh, it's Asensio, so he's like invincible, probably. There we go.
La ciudad universitaria no resistirá mucho.
Hey, we took the university. More story time in Spanish.
El gobierno republicano decide trasladar las Cortes a Valencia ante el acoso nacional a Madrid. La ciudad sufre el continuo bombardeo de los aviones Heinkel alemanes, fieles a la causa nacional. Pero la situación cambia cuando sobre el cielo de la capital aparecen los primeros aviones rusos, más modernos que sus antagonistas italo-germanos y pilotados por experimentados soldados soviéticos. Estos aviones, castizamente apodados Chatos y Moscas, acaban con la supremacía aérea nacional en Madrid. El 20 de noviembre se da por terminada la primera ofensiva sobre la capital de España. El año 1937 comienza con una guerra civil española totalmente internacionalizada. Mientras Francia cierra su frontera con la España republicana, desembarcan en Cádiz los primeros contingentes italianos al frente del general fascista Roata. El apoyo del Corpo di Truppe Volontarie y la aviación legionaria resultarán piezas valiosas para el despliegue militar nacional. Durante los primeros días del año, se suceden los enfrentamientos en las inmediaciones de Madrid por parte de ambos bandos. Es al inicio del mes de febrero cuando los rebeldes, convencidos de que una toma directa de Madrid resultaría extremadamente ardua, deciden rodear totalmente la capital. 50.000 hombres al mando del general rebelde Orgaz toman la localidad de Ciempozuelos con un objetivo en mente: cruzar el río Jarama para establecer una cabeza de puente en el Cerro del Pingarón. Por su parte, las fuerzas republicanas sitúan a lo mejor de sus tropas militares para evitar el avance nacional. La batalla del Jarama ha comenzado.
Alright guys, here we are. Jerome Valley, February 10th, 1937. So we're in the new year of the war. The Jerome River is too grown to be forded. Take the bridge becomes a target priority for the national progress. Pindoque Bridge looks like the best option, but the Republican forces are not going to make it easy or contest or taking positions in the nearby hill of Pingarión. Pindoque Bridge.
Hemos de actuar con sigilo. Debemos encontrar la manera de atravesar el río y tomar por sorpresa a los centinelas. Recordad que hemos de ser sigilosos como fantasmas.
So here goes. I actually think
allí hay uno.
The voice actor is definitely Mustafa. The voice actor that is our character is definitely the Moroccan troop, but if you actually look at my hand, it's white, so I'm not entirely sure if we're supposed to be now the Moroccan troop or not. Could be. Okay, I actually have to press shift to attack. It's actually very fun that we have a sort of like stealth section here, even with Call of Duty 2, that wasn't such a thing as stealth. Well, so much for stealth. Here we go. I do actually have a grenade. Oh my god, so many. That actually was their own grenade that killed them. We grew with the whole squad. All right, just gathering some ammo here. What are we doing? Regroup.
Señor, no queda ninguno con vida.
Tenemos órdenes de seguir avanzando hacia el vértice Pingarón.
Pingarón.
Según nuestros mapas, debe haber un caserío al este.
Oh, here we go. Conquer the top and ensure the farmhouse. here we go.
En marcha.
That must be the farmhouse. Wow, beautiful. That was a great grenade. Oh God. Okay, we ensure the farmhouse, but there are definitely still enemies here. I heard a grenade. It's interesting that sometimes it doesn't actually give you the grenade icon in this. Oh, here we go. Give me that revolver. Is there a second floor here? It'd be very useful to fire from that position. Oh, here we go. That's a little far. Be a sniper here, that would be magnifico. Oh yeah, I forgot that you run faster if you hold out your sidearm. Bombers? Oh God! Man, he's not kidding. So much smoke. Alright. Didn't take too many casualties there. Could have been a lot worse. I think there's actually one in the window over there. I think from cover to cover, from little cover there is. Oh. But I do have a grenade. Eat this, communist pigs. That grenade still grazed me. Okay, we could get some ammo for my revolver here. There we go. Nope, different pistol that they're using. Alright, still have to conquer the top. Not too sure where that machine gunner is.
Another.
They are spread out here. They have angles on all of us. We saw that we have some G's here now. Not the strongest weapons, but they'll help. Grenade! I can return the favor. Reinforcements incoming. Invisible wall here. Is that it?
Preparemos la defensa. Seguro que el enemigo prepara un contraataque.
Oh, they're coming. Oh, they have a tank. Defended, huh? Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. What do we do, sir? Retreating? Yep.
Run for your life!
Take the sticky bombs. Are the sticky bombs? Yes, no, no one. Or is it actually up here? Oh, yeah, okay.
El generalísimo no aceptará una derrota.
En marcha.
All right. Use sticky bombs to destroy the enemy tank. You can leave that to me. And hopefully the AI will deal with the remainder of the enemy NPCs. That did not go very well. Okay, yeah, they're just getting reinforcements. We have to get rid of that tank. Oh, I have to stand behind it. Ooh, the turret is actually aiming at me. victory or death.
Demostraremos a estos extranjeros cómo luchamos con la guerra.
Oh my god, more incoming. How many are they gonna send? There we go. Victory or death!
El gobierno republicano decide trasladar las Cortes a Valencia ante el acoso nacional a Madrid. La ciudad queda al mando de una junta de defensa y de un comandante en jefe, el general Miaja. La sorprendente resistencia de la capital corre a cargo del teniente coronel Rojo, apoyado entre otros por las recién formadas brigadas internacionales, la columna anarquista de Durruti y sobre todo por la aviación rusa. A pesar de que Madrid sufre los continuos bombardeos italo-germanos, los experimentados aviadores soviéticos acaban con la superioridad nacional en el cielo de la capital. Gracias a la planificación táctica por tierra y aire, Madrid acaba el año resistiendo firmemente las acometidas rebeldes. El año 1937 comienza con una guerra civil española totalmente internacionalizada. Un gran número de voluntarios de varios países atraviesa la frontera francesa para luchar al lado de los republicanos, mientras efectivos rebeldes como la Legión Cóndor Alemana bombardean plazas como Cartagena o Bilbao. El bando nacional, sorprendido ante la resistencia inquebrantable de Madrid, comienza a preparar su expansión en otros frentes de la península. Desembarcan en Cádiz los primeros contingentes italianos comandados por el general fascista Roata, el Corpo di Truppe Volontarie. Franco envía inmediatamente a los italianos a atacar la importante plaza de Málaga. Los efectivos republicanos de la ciudad, acosados, desmoralizados y en franca desventaja, apenas resisten los ataques de las tropas de Mussolini.
All right, here we have some text again. Jarama Valley, February 10th, 1937. The Republican forces have managed to abort the capture of Madrid by the Nationals. The rebels then initiate a new strategy, cut communication and supply routes of the capital. The Loyalists have lost ground against the enemy's raids that have taken over positions as Coberteras Hill strategically important bridges that cross the flow of the Jarama. With the help of the international brigades, Republicans must capture new enclaves and defend at all costs. So now we are switching sides again. We're fighting for the Republic.
Los nacionales han tomado el vértice de Coberteras. Hemos perdido la posición.
Debo informar de la pérdida de Coberteras a las tropas inglesas y americanas de la 15ª Brigada Internacional.
Look at that. The British and the Americans are fighting with us. Nationals, the fascist pigs, are now trying to cut off our communications. Let's see if we can hold them. This mission is called Suicide Hill, so I assume it's going to be a hill defense. Inform the international brigades. Are there actually going to be Americans among these troops? It's gonna be interesting.
Comrades, we have just lost Coberteras, so be careful. Enemies near.
Don't worry. We and our machine guns are all prepared.
We strongly have to defend this position. Don't let the enemy reach this hill.
We will eliminate every last damn fascist in the world.
¿Se puede saber qué les has dicho? No me fío de ellos.
Tranquilo. La fortuna de mi revulsivo padre no sirvió para educarme como a la niñita que él quería, pero al menos sirvió para pagar buenos profesores de inglés. Les he instado a defender la posición. Estos soldados han viajado miles de kilómetros para luchar contra los fascistas. Si hay alguien en esta guerra en los que podemos confiar, esos son las brigadas internacionales.
Look at that! So they actually did what I talked about before, about actually having that in their native tongue. Again, it might be a bit more difficult to do that with German-speaking than as an American. Alright, here they come. Already threw up a smoke curtain. Here they come. Oh, look at that horde. Defend the hill until reinforcements arrive. That sounds like artillery. Take cover from the barrage. Oh god! Oh god! This is heavier than I thought. Get in the house! That's their artillery. They are killing their own units as well. Everybody's going outside as if the barrage is over, but from entering and attacking the White House. Okay, so we have to actually defend this. That is going to be a bit more difficult than the game makes it out to be. How did they already flank us all the way over there? What the hell? Is that enemy too? No. It is sometimes a little confusing if, like, the mission before you were fighting as one side and then you switch. Just gotta flip that mind state of, like, okay, now I'm on the opposite side. So the guys I just called my friends are now my enemies. Here comes the next wave. Oh. Large numbers are heading over there. Just keep them away from the White House. Quick ammo sweep here. If those guys are able to flank, they could definitely attack the White House. Ugh, another wave incoming. Another grenade I could use just in case. Didn't bounce as much as I wanted to, that grenade. It immediately stopped where I threw it. Okay, more ammo.
No pasarán.
A las armas. We got a checkpoint here. Reinforcements, 5 minutes. All right. It's a little bit too quiet. Okay, got 81 bullets. That is something. That's
another artillery strike! Get to cover!
So, I guess if worse comes to worse, I can use this. This machine gun right here. But you don't have a vision on the enemy until they're super close to the house. So it's not ideal. I'm also pretty low on ammo for this thing right here. Now, of course, oh, geez, now they're probably gonna keep coming for the next 3.5 minutes, so. Let's make those bullets count. Oh, they got Italians with them too. Less than 3 minutes. Come on. Okay, got a checkpoint. No, I see them heading towards that house. Don't you do it. Dirty fascists. You deserve a bullet. Uh-oh. Oh dear. This is where things go wrong. Screw it. Oh! Yep, no, they overwhelmed me. I got out of, ran out of ammo. Luckily, I didn't lose too much. Progress. Taking a fascist weapon, better than a communist weapon without ammo. Grenade now, though. Here. Now that I know it doesn't bounce. Of Wheater saying. Less than 2 minutes. A lot of ammo there. Alright, they're popping new smoke. Yep, they're starting to spawn right there, over there. Throw a grenade. Retreating! Back.
Die, fascists!
Medic!
Llegan los refuerzos rusos.
Nice. Reinforcements have arrived, even though there's still 30 seconds. Here we go. We got the Pavlov tank. Take them all out. Slaughter them all. Yeah! Give it to them. No mercy for fascists. The planes are also coming, bombarding them. Let's enjoy this moment of death. I'm here. Did not trigger it.
Potentes tanques del ejército aplastarán a esos fascistas.
Gracias. Es bueno saber que nuestros hermanos soviéticos están dispuestos a compartir con nosotros algo más que la ideología.
Estos vehículos, ningún enemigo podrá detenernos.
There we fall like you sons of the people. Out of the people they bring in. Now we're far.
La batalla del Jarama se erige como uno de los más cruentos enfrentamientos de toda la Guerra Civil Española. A pesar de que ambos bandos se adjudican la victoria, el número de bajas es desolador. Aproximadamente unas 20.000 víctimas totales, entre las que se incluyen los cerca de 2.500 efectivos pertenecientes a las brigadas internacionales. Los rebeldes logran cruzar el Jarama, aunque no consiguen cortar totalmente las comunicaciones de la capital con Valencia. Por su parte, las tropas republicanas demuestran finalmente que cuentan con un ejército disciplinado y eficaz. Los nacionales, ayudados por efectivos internacionales como la Legión Cóndor Alemana, aterrizada en marzo en Sevilla, continúan el ataque a las plazas republicanas. Ejemplos como el bombardeo sobre Barcelona a mediados de febrero o la toma de Málaga por parte de los italianos de Mussolini evidencian la expansión del dominio de los sublevados en gran parte del país. Los nacionales inician entonces una nueva ofensiva para tomar o como mínimo cercar nuevamente la capital española. Para ello concentran en Guadalajara un gran número de efectivos a la altura de Sigüenza. El rápido avance de las tropas nacionales e italianas allí apostadas augura una victoria fulgurante.
Alright, here we are. March 9th, 1937. Guadalajara. The rebel troops want to be in once all the tactical control of the Spanish capital. With help from the Italian troops, breaking the seemingly weak Republican line does not seem too much to do. Thus begins March 8th, the Battle of Guadalajara. The national Italian troops and take Almadrones. The defense of these resources is important to the conquest of Guadalajara. But the Italians will soon discover that this battle will be not as simple as they think.
Signore Ferrero, hemos localizado un punto con abundantes reservas de combustible y granjas cercanas.
Muchacho, llámame simplemente Mateo. En el campo de batalla todos somos iguales. Tenemos que tomar ese almacén y todas las granjas que encontremos. Sin esos recursos, estaremos en desventaja ante el enemigo, ya que no podremos ofrecerle resistencia alguna a los mortíferos tanques soviéticos.
A sus órdenes.
All right, here we go. We are fighting as the Italians once more. Which is again very cool. We got Guilani, Valente, Barico. We have a lot of areas to either destroy or take.
Atentos que viene!
Oh, that's an invisible wall. I cannot actually hide behind that. That was not good. So after the defense of Suicide Hill, now back as the Nationals. Die, communist pigs! Oh god. The only good red is a dead rat. Not entirely sure where that grenade landed. Ugh, it's another one of those. That's so weird that those doors and fences you think you can shoot through, you cannot actually. That's actually part of what we need to destroy, isn't it? Yep. Here we go. Destroy this. Alright, all objectives cleared in this area. This is an invisible wall in the wooded area. Entirely sure where we are regrouping. Don't destroy this, no. Oh, I guess I'm going into the open nothingness. Uh-oh. Friend or foe? Italia. Alright, still have a lot to destroy. This is a little awkward. Oh, this is an invisible wall. So I guess those troops are heading over there. And I'm heading this way. By myself, unfortunately. Already see troops, and those are friendly. Good, good, good. Giuseppe, it is I.
He encontrado algunos compatriotas italianos en la carretera.
Señor, las únicas tropas italianas en la zona somos nosotros. Debe tratarse del batallón Garibaldi de las Brigadas Internacionales Republicanas.
¡Porca miseria! Nos obligan a derramar la sangre de nuestros propios hermanos.
No tenemos elección. O ellos, o nosotros.
Oh, interesting. So the Italians actually fought on both sides. That's almost a mini sort of civil war in and of itself for the Italians then. Can you imagine you volunteer to fight in a different country? And then you just, that actually happened to the Irish with the American Civil War. where the Irish actually fought on both sides. And there were even battles where the Irish fought against each other. And again, it's like you go to a different country to volunteer. Well, I don't think there were volunteers back then, but you go there, you know, voluntarily, and then you end up fighting your own countrymen. I mean, that must hurt. I will say, though, with how messed up the world is nowadays, with how everybody, you know, wants to cancel each other all the time, it almost seems like people nowadays had no problem fighting against their own countrymen, because they are complaining about each other the entire time when one looks on social media. Oh, we got a new SMG here. Alright, so just have to pull through here. The spacing is too wide. I either need... Ideally, I would have smoke grenades to cover the approach. Oh. Good thing he switched over to attack me in melee range. Okay, that's death dealt with. One more stock of ammunition and two fuel barrels. What are they doing? Oh, shot my own guy there. Why were they like waving their hands when they were running like that? What's happening? Ugh, of course, I cannot shoot through that. I keep forgetting it. That should count for two. Alright, only one more stock of ammunition. Oh god. At least we have a lot of units here. I'm throwing a grenade too, bitch. Here you go. He threw it right back. No one else has more of that SMG ammo. Here we go. Final one. I need to switch weapons.
Rápido! Aunque lo deteste, debemos abandonar la zona.
Retreat to a safer position. Alright. I have zero weapons. I mean, even if I had ammo, there's nothing I could do against those tanks. Where the hell did everybody go?
señor. La mayoría de nuestros efectivos han desertado.
No les reprocho nada. Ya no le encuentro sentido a pasar zombando a toda velocidad entre balas italianas. Me pregunto qué se le habrá perdido a Mussolini en esta tierra dejada de la mano de Dios. Está bien. Agrupémonos y...
¡Llegan las tropas enviadas por el general Franco!
¡Justo a tiempo! ¡Bienvenidos sean!
Saludos del general Varela y del generalísimo. ¿Cómo está la situación?
Debemos lanzar un contraataque rápido y contundente en menos de 15 minutos para pillarlos por sorpresa.
¿Y a qué estamos esperando?
All right. We're back to taking the town. Okay, now at least I can get all this ammo right here. Oh! Oh god! What do we do here with that? Oh, there's another tank. Yeah, that tank's gonna be a problem. That one here is dead. Oh, jeez.
Get to cover! Oh.
Oh my goodness. I don't know where the final checkpoint was. Okay, here. Okay, that one tank to the right is easy. Oh, not okay, lol. I actually remembered the weapon switch I did after this. There we go. He's also, the turret is immediately pointed towards me. Hold on, let me see if there's a way to flank it. I don't think so. Okay. Just gonna try it again. Here. Oh, Jesus. Yo! See you in hell. Another communist cooked. He's going to die by his own grenade. Oh my god! That was karma right there. I have to do this shit over again. Damn it. Can get, of course, impatient if you have to do this over and over again. That's kind of not what you want in this situation. There we go. Take it out. Yep. Retreat. All a matter of thinning out the herd.
Ese es el
Bel lavoro di squadra.
I will not let you up again. Okay, we just need to take the town, that's our main thing. I guess it's a wine, vinos. A wine cellar. Throwing another grenade. Be careful, guys. And they have a sniper up there, too. I heard another grenade. Hoping to throw it in the house. Oh, what the hell? Thank you. Oh, he's in the house there. Dirty. Is that not an enemy? Oh, it's that thing again with there where he's behind the balcony thing and it's impenetrable. Alright, a pistol would be useful here now. Crap.
Get out!
Oh. Thank you for your pistol. One bullet. Anyone want to do Russian roulette? Not too sure if I need to kill literally every enemy here, or if we're done. Or is there more? Oh, there is more. Well, actually, we're coming back now to here. Oh, wow. My guy has the worst throwing strength. Come on, show your face. There we go. Not entirely sure if I need to head to a specific location or need to talk to someone. This seems like a municipal building. Kinda where like the final battle would take place. Everyone's here is dead. Unless, again, unless you literally need to kill every last enemy in the area. He's still there.
Este punto de nuevo en nuestro poder y los refuerzos del general Franco, la victoria sobre el enemigo es inminente. ¡Pandiamo!
¡Victoria! ¡Hemos acabado con esos espaguetis comunistas!
Oh, return to base. I thought it was over. Is there actually a path through here? This is all invisible walls. Unless you open the door for me. No. Okay, I guess I have to take the long way out. I need to. Ah, okay, look. Now I do need to go here.
¿Dónde vas, soldado? Vuelvo a Italia. Nada puedo hacer ya aquí. Y nada me retiene. Ni siquiera mis hombres. Podía sentir la emoción de la guerra. Y he descubierto que es un sinsentido.
Ven con nosotros y únete al batallón Garibaldi de las Brigadas Internacionales. Aún hay italianos que luchan por la libertad y contra el fascismo.
Estoy cansado de luchar.
La defensa de Madrid se hace cada vez más ardua debido al férreo avance de las tropas rebeldes. La población en masa se apiña en las calles, cavando trincheras, preparando defensas y alzando parapetos improvisados. El grito de «No pasarán», célebre frase de Dolores Ibárruri, la pasionaria en nombre del Partido Comunista, se convierte en una consigna que resuena en todos los rincones de la capital. En este panorama de incertidumbre, la República consigue grandes avances en el ámbito social. Tras denodados esfuerzos, el orden público comienza a estabilizarse y a mantenerse sin miramientos. Se paralizan las detenciones arbitrarias y los registros si estos no son autorizados por el gobierno. Se arrebata la hegemonía del orden público a los anarquistas en Cataluña y se proclama la igualdad entre hombres y mujeres en territorio republicano. Tras el sangriento desenlace de la Batalla del Jarama y el decisivo papel de las Brigadas Internacionales en la defensa del territorio republicano, las tropas rebeldes inician de nuevo en marzo de 1937 el asalto a la capital de España. A tal efecto se concentran miles de tropas italianas en el noreste de Madrid, a la altura de Guadalajara, apoyadas por tanques, camiones, piezas de artillería ligera y cazas. Los italianos, dispuestos a repetir una aplastante victoria como la de Málaga, actúan de forma autónoma con el consentimiento del gobierno de Burgos. Las fuerzas republicanas, apoyadas por las Brigadas Internacionales, entre las que se encuentran los italianos antifascistas del batallón Garibaldi, se preparan para frenar el avance insurrecto.
All right, here we are, still in Guadalajara. March 14, 1937. The first Italian assault on the Republican position in Guadalajara has been devastating, but the situation is good for the Republican army. The gathering storm hovering over the battlefields to prevent them to take the rebel fighters, or for the takeoff of rebel fighters, and slow the progress of the Italian tanks. The enemy also has to fight their own countrymen, Italian anti-fascists, who are part of the Republican army. It's time to take advantage of all these tactical advantages. So now we might actually be playing as the Italians, but on the other side. Oh no, there's Russians.
Thank you.
Or maybe they're just talking about motherland Russia because they're communist. I'm not entirely sure. Because all their names are very Italian. I'm just going to keep it to that we're now fighting as the Italians, but then on the Republican side. Oh dear.
Get off!
Run to cover.
It's an ambush!
Oh, grenade galore. Yep, this is now exactly what they're talking about. We're Italians fighting Italians. Sharing the blood of our brothers for a different country's sake. It's all about ideology in that sense. Oh, nice dodge. I cannot help you there, buddy. Oh. Just gonna take a look if there's something up here. Doesn't seem like it. Eliminate resistance, regroup with the Commissar. Can do. More Italian flags right over there. We have to now regroup again. Where the tanks are, let's see. Oh yeah.
Tommy, disable the flak with your explosives. Let's.
Camarada Brezé. Comandante Ignacio Hidalgo de Cisneros ha localizado una base italiana del CTV cerca de nuestra posición.
Rápido, ataquemos al enemigo antes de que puedan localizarnos.
Attack the Italian base. Oh, that spawned enemies here. I thought with the amount of cover that was like, this is like a perfect ambush or fighting location. One less fascist to worry about.
Squadra, fuoco di copertura.
But with Mussolini, you'd think that these Italians that fight for the Republic, they cannot go back to Italy. So maybe that's why they were talking about glorious Russia. Maybe they just were living in other countries, but they were still Italians, volunteering for this this cause.
No era más que un pequeño puesto de observación. Seguro que tienen otra fortaleza cercana. Debemos localizarla y barrer a todos los enemigos del mapa. ¡Por la madre Rusia!
Tranquilo, camarada. No podemos arreglar todo en esta guerra a tiros.
¿Quién eres?
Mi nombre es Gustav Regler, escritor y comisario de la 12ª Brigada Internacional.
Pero tú eres alemán, ¿no? Cerdos de la Legión Cóndor.
Tranquilo, Tovarich. Estoy de tu lado. Además, yo no tengo nada que ver con esos fanáticos de Hitler.
Alegra comprobar que no todos los alemanes sois unos asesinos fascistas. Bueno, ¿Tienes algo que explicarnos? No sé cómo será en Alemania. Aquí el enemigo no espera.
Camarada, he comprobado que la mayoría de los soldados que luchan en el bando nacional son italianos. Muchos están aquí en contra de su voluntad. Y una guerra tan larga y dura puede haberles minado la moral. Estoy convencido de que podría destrozarles los ánimos. Permíteme usar los altavoces y el gramófono de esa torre de comunicaciones abandonada.
Intenta lo que quieras. No interfieras en mis planes o en los de mis hombres. Pero es como si las rojitas poesía cantara.
All right, here we go. It's actually very cool that we have now a German over here, but again, because he speaks Spanish and he just looks like this, I couldn't really tell that he was German.
Soldados del ejército italiano, habéis sido engañados, vendidos, conducidos al matadero por vuestros jefes. Habéis empuñado las armas.
Oh, Christ. That's gonna be a great grenade. No, don't throw it back, bitch. Spain to the Spanish. Well said. I need to also switch weapon. Take the palace. Oh, here we go. We got a ladder, everybody. Up the ladder. Up, 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 up. We got McManus over here. We have all sorts of international people here. Oh, hell no. Yeah, don't you move. Don't you move. We are in control now. How do we go down here? Yeah. Come on, boys, for Italy. Oh, okay. That thing's active. Well, let me see if I can land an explosive on it. Don't drive me over. Don't drive me over. Oh, it's a good tank. What the hell? Why was it shooting at us? No! Okay, we have a foothold in the area. I can get a grenade in there. Oh! Sneaky bastard. Is that on the second floor of that? Oh yeah, they had do have machine gun nests up in the second floor. That's deadly. Difficult to spot too. In. You could climb up there by the ladder. I guess we'll deal with that first. Surprise, bitch! Don't you dare. Not too sure if I hit someone there, but... Oh, also one here. Present. This is a pretty big area with a lot of units still alive. Come on, fascist, where are you hiding? Ooh, that was a close call. Oh, now we have to defend it. Where did all these guys come from? Wait, I have the machine gun up there on the second floor. It doesn't turn more to the left. It's kind of useless. The one in the barn might even be more useful, but we'll deal with it. Did I get him? Yep. Just has his pistol left. He's wounded. We can bleed him out, or the AI can take care of him. One left. You can run all you want. No! Oh, damn it. If that grenade was actually would have gone off, it would have killed so many. There we go. Regroup with the squad. Can do. Even took some wine for the good commander. Alright everybody, here we have the next mission with some text in Brihuega, March 18th, 1937. The Italian troops trying to stabilize the front of Brihuega, but leave a lot of materials and vehicles. While the Republicans take a strategy uniting all the forces to conquer the people, are beginning to see first bombing of the day on the town, while Lister and Mira attack from the west, making them withdraw. Thus begins the advance of the Russian tanks. The Italians use their artillery to try and stop them. And here we go. This is one of the coolest things in this mod. I did not think this would be in here, but we have an actual tank mission as a T-26 tank. I mean, how cool is that? This is not even a custom tank that is in the game. It is absolutely fantastic. Let's roll out. Destroy all positions of anti-tank guns. 8. Machine gun will automatically fire. Okay, I don't have to worry about that. Are my other tanks coming with me? Yes, they are. Of course, the audio that they have for the tanks is only British. Because... Oh, no, they do have Spanish dialogue. Okay, interesting. Very cool. Again, this mod has it all. It has turret sections. Oh, it has tank sections. It's not really a stealth section, but just so much variety. This is literally, I cannot praise this mod enough. It is one of the best mods out there of all time. Oh, nope, but there we went. That was a little bit too much. I am absolutely not in a good position here. Oh my god. Okay, you know what? We're gonna stay a little bit back. Let's stay a little bit back. Let's actually attack him from this spot right here. Ugh. That's one. Gotta hit in. Have to hit him at least twice. I cannot move
backwards.
There we go. Alright, let's gather some health again. Still need to destroy this one for the objective. There we go. Moving forward. This one's destroyed. Next up. Oh. Good kill. Moving through. Oh, sneaky bastard. Just using it as a static turret, almost. Trying to move back. There we go. First of many. It's only one left, actually. Oh, well. Good thing that those guys are sleeping. Destroy the enemy tank. Oh, God. Oh, no. He's gonna fire. Okay. Whew.
Russia.
Short mission, but absolutely awesome.
El
en principio imparable avance de las tropas italianas desde el frente de Guadalajara se convirtió en cuestión de días en una clamorosa retirada. Las tropas republicanas pasan de tener un papel defensivo a adoptar una postura totalmente ofensiva, consiguiendo rechazar a los efectivos del general Roata y reconquistando territorio rebelde. El frente italiano pronto se convierte en un repliegue desordenado, finalizando a mediados de marzo la batalla de Guadalajara. Ante el continuo fracaso en la toma de Madrid, los nacionales deciden cambiar de objetivos. Por el momento, la República ha ganado la partida. La nueva estrategia del gobierno de Burgos será la conquista de Bilbao, Santander y Asturias en la llamada Campaña del Norte. El gobierno republicano recibe con preocupación informes que confirman la concentración de gran parte de la aviación alemana e italiana en Vitoria. Pero no es hasta finales de marzo cuando los nacionales inician una ofensiva que hace retroceder lenta, pero inexorablemente a las fuerzas leales. El frente del País Vasco, primero en recibir los ataques, lo integran cerca de 30.000 hombres. Las fuerzas republicanas de Euskadi que se enfrentan a los rebeldes están compuestas por 27 batallones de las fuerzas nacionalistas vascas, conocidas como Gudaris, y una amalgama de socialistas, comunistas, anarquistas y republicanos de izquierdas. Los nacionales, que doblan en hombres y cuadriplican aproximadamente en materiales a los experimentados Gudaris, van ganando posiciones de forma aplastante. El 31 de marzo, bombarderos alemanes Junker 52 inician la ofensiva sobre el norte, atacando Durango, que se convierte en la primera población indefensa bombardeada de Europa. Siguen a este los bombardeos de ciudades como Ochandiano o Bilbao, que preceden el avance por tierra y posterior toma de posiciones estratégicas republicanas por parte de los insurrectos durante todo el mes de abril. Es entonces cuando un grupo de aviones de la Legión Cóndor alemana protagoniza un episodio que conmociona a la opinión pública internacional.
All right, here we are. The next mission. Let's read. We're in Guernica, April 26, 1937. On April 26, 1937, the town of Guernica, without any strategic intervals, is bombed indiscriminately. The town is practically destroyed, almost completely. One of the many terrified civilians runs to escape death from the sky, dispensing Italian and German bombing before the city is completely devastated. Should reach the symbol of the Basque freedoms, the Oak of Guernica. Bombed indiscriminately. That is horrible. Oh no. Look at all these wounded. Iker and Javier. Oh! Another bomb that just went off a little bit too late. I cannot move. Oh, I hear ya! I hear ya! Where are you? Keep shouting. Civil rescues from rubble. Find a cure. Oh, you have a time limit for this. Here.
Dios se lo pague.
Todavía no ha terminado el bombardeo. Y la aviación sigue ametrallando sin compasión a todo lo que se mueve. Rápido. Tenemos que alcanzar un lugar seguro. He oído que la casa de juntas y el árbol de Guernica siguen intactos. No perdamos tiempo. Vamos.
Sí, seguro que podremos refugiarnos allí.
Aranguren. Okay. It's a difficult name. But here we go. You coming with me? There we go. Stay close. Ugh, look at all these wounded here.
Incoming aircraft!
Oh, take another cover! Bombing run. Alright, didn't seem like they dropped bombs over here. After you, mate. I'm not too sure where we're heading.
Oh, God! Bombers!
Is he dead? No.
Run!
Get out of the street! Oh my goodness. Everybody's running. Oh God. That's him with the wounded that he dragged before. Oh no, they didn't make it. The Germans and the Italians are bombing us.
Horrible war crime.
Oh, he uses the animation from the Quad Hook. That was cool.
Oh! Get inside!
Oh my God! There's nothing out there but dust and smoke. Yours seem to be okay, though. Man, these guys are terrified. There's nothing they can do with their guns. Oh. Oh, that's cool. This is actually... This is also a super original level and very cool where you... It doesn't seem like you actually get to shoot. It's just all sort of like an adventure game. Just very interesting. Oh, wait. I can't actually go through.
Oh! Run!
Oh, Christ. Oh, God. Am I dead? I'm dead. They had a plane with actually... Oh, I'm here. That actually shot at us. I'm not entirely sure if I should stand, like, keep standing there, or if I should run. Like, what do we do here? He just stands there. They get mowed down. Oh, now he's running. Yeah, I don't know. Okay. We're gonna have a little bit of trial and error here. I think if you keep standing there, he'll probably shoot you. So we'll run from the beginning. Oh my God, I'm still alive. Just as I said that, I die. I don't know if I can go into those buildings. Or if I should be right on the Aranguren's ass. This works a little iffy. There we go. Okay, yeah. That's what you do. Oh!
What happens? I can't hear it and see shit. Oh, God. I'm still alive.
Oh! Oh, God. Please make it stop. Oh, my God, we got a checkpoint. Where's my buddy? Where's my friend? Where is everybody? There he is.
Oh! Oh, make it stop! Make the bombing stop! Come on! We come
in! You don't have to tell me that twice. Oh, there's the tree. Oh my God, all these wounded. The sign of freedom.
No sé cómo pagarle lo que ha hecho por nosotros. Siempre está.
No se preocupe. Cualquiera habría hecho lo mismo de estar en mi lugar.
There we go. People, I am going to end the video here. Don't worry, I haven't done all these missions all on the same day, just different recordings. But I am going to make this a part one. Let me know if you do want to see part two. I think there are like still 7 or 8 missions left until we complete the game. So it's actually still quite a while to go. I mean, in story-wise, the war is still going to continue for 2 more years. So yeah, let me know if you guys like this. Again, you can download this mod in the description down below. Definitely check it out. It is one of the coolest mods ever made for any game, and definitely for any Call of Duty game. And I cannot praise this enough. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.